So it's been almost 10 months since we started Strada, and today is about testing. I'm nervous today because we haven't actually seen it work yet. So we're here in Big Bear, which is a couple hours outside of LA. And what we're doing is we're documenting a crew that's actually shooting a reality game show.
Our contestants are searching for hidden treasure worth $50,000.
But what we're doing is we're going to run this footage through Strada's Tag Analyze AI engine. We're gonna be able to analyze the footage, see the people, see the objects, see the locations, see the specific things that are happening. That way, when you're in post-production, you can search for a person, a location, an object, an emotion, a reaction. When you're looking for stuff and you need to find it quickly, a lot of times, if it's not memorized, you have to scrub and you have to look for that. What we're trying to do with Strada is automate that and make it happen so fast because we can use AI to actually search for those items for you. We've theorized, we've built it, we've done some tests, but now we're gonna put it into practice. Okay, this is a super exciting workflow episode because I think what we're about to do is a first in the filmmaking industry. I realize that's a big claim, but what we're going to do is take the results of AI analysis and connect it to editors. But before we can do that, if you haven't yet watched episode 28, please pause this episode and go back and watch episode 28 and see how we got the AI engine to initially work in Strada. Because at the time of recording this episode on location, we had never run a multicam set of footage through the system. And even if we can accurately analyze the data, we've never gotten that metadata to travel into the cutting room. But that's what today is all about. We want to know if the Strada Tag Analyze will be able to identify these elements and then be able to make that faster to find and search. So as the cameras roll, the contestants are wearing mics, and so we're able to transcribe what they're saying. So think about the combination here. If you have a little bit of data about a location, like a tent or a backpack, and then you have a little bit of data about a time of day, is it night or is it daytime? And then you have a little bit of information about what they said. You recall something. I hurt my foot. I have blisters. Ah,
blisters.
Can we triangulate between blister and a person and a location and actually take a whole bunch of files and narrow it down to just a couple? At the moment of this recording, we don't know if that's going to work. When I think about the long list of challenges that editing rooms face throughout the entire post-production process, the idea of creating a tool that makes it faster to find things lives at the top of that list. Because AI models can work in the background, it seems like using AI to improve search would be super valuable to creative teams. Plus, AI can work all night. It never gets tired, and it doesn't care if you shoot too much. AI can analyze dozens of hours of material and deliver results that are numerous and accurate. This project is called Camp Cash, and the crew followed two contestants and captured more than a dozen hours of material. Once loaded into the cloud, it takes one click and Strada analyzes objects, locations, props, people, actions, and even emotions. Tags are time-coded to each individual clip, and since each clip is different, the list of tags becomes unique, often containing more than 50 logs per asset. If we click through different clips, you'll notice how Strada's AI analysis delivers an elegant map of every moment taking place in a clip. These act like fingerprints, which means Strada is able to understand the unique characteristics of every one of your assets. That means you can search by any one of those tags. We even added an AI tags menu that displays what Strada identified across your entire set of media. Our vision for Strada is simple: to allow everyone working on a collaborative team to locate the moments they're looking for without having to wait. We proved in episode 28 that Strada can analyze a lot of media in large batches, tag the video, and transcribe the audio, which unlocks a searchable database unlike anything else in the market. We even added the ability to invite your creative partners into a project, so creative teams can access the same search database and organize the results collaboratively. And since Strada lives in the cloud, I can access it on my computer wherever I go. But as helpful as it is to search for a keyword or a moment in Strada, there's a new problem that we have to solve. How does an editor take advantage of the metadata Strada was able to generate? Well, to do that, we need to create a way to export the AI database. And since editors can't agree on an editing platform, we have to make it work with four different NLEs. So let's start with DaVinci Resolve. First, we go into Strada and we choose a bin full of analyzed clips we want to export. Then we right-click and select Export for DaVinci Resolve. This generates a zip file which automatically can be downloaded. When you unzip this file, you'll see the CSV. If we head over to DaVinci Resolve, I have all my media loaded from the shoot. I can put it in column view and right-click on the columns and select the checkbox for keywords. Right now, this column is blank since we only imported the raw media. Now I can go to the file menu, select Import Metadata to Media Pool, and select the Strada CSV. In the pop-up, I'm gonna check Ignore File Extensions when matching. Once you hit OK, you'll receive a success window, and now we can see the keyword column instantly populated with thousands of tags from the Strada AI database. So if I wanna start searching, I can go to the upper right and click on the search tool. Be sure to select the keyword column since that's where the tags live. And now I can search and resolve exactly the same way as I did in Strada. Right now, there are 274 clips in the media pool, but I need to find one shot of the cabin that was by the lake. If I search lake, that's already narrowed it down to 81. Well, that's better, but still too many to look through. What if I type in the word cabin? Well, now there are 22, so that's getting better. But what happens if I combine the words lake and cabin together in the search? Aha, we get down to 3, and now I can find the best moment of the shot of the cabin by the lake. Remember, all of the logging here was done automatically in Strada. No one had to input a single character. But there's another trick in Resolve that might help you in search. These are called smart bins. What you see on the left are all the individual tags that Strada created. And as you click through the smart bins, each bin is automatically populated with the assets that contain that specific tag. Now, I know there's a moment in the show where the female contestant finds a clue written on a piece of paper. If I just scroll down to the bin called paper, well, look at that. Here's the clip I want, automatically put into a bin all by itself. Smart bins in search also work in the edit tool. So if I need to edit a story moment around the contestant that sprained his ankle, I can search injury and drag and drop those assets into the timeline to edit. Now let's bring Strada's metadata into Final Cut Pro. We start by exporting an FCP XML from Strada. We can then double-click that file, select a Final Cut library we want the assets to be in, and then we're given two powerful ways to search for files in Final Cut. First, we see an event from Strada, and it's in a folder called Strada Analysis. If we open this up, we have a similar experience to Resolve's smart bins. Each keyword that was tagged in Strada automatically shows up as a collection of clips that you can search through. Let's try searching for emotions. My producer wants to find a shot of the woman contestant looking surprised. I can click on the surprise collection, but remember, Strada already logged the time codes for each time it detected the element of surprise. So Final Cut has already subclipped these moments and grouped them into the Surprise Smart Collection. This is totally automatic. So I can go through and quickly watch each time there is a surprised reaction. These are separated even in the same take. Strada's ability to add AI tags to Final Cut ranges is possibly the most powerful way to speed up your searches. Next, let's go back to Strada and export an XML for Adobe Premiere Pro. In Premiere, I can simply import and navigate to the XML we generated in Strada. What's great about this is that Strada already created bins for us based on the keywords. Even better, each of these bins contains subclips. Similar to Final Cut ranges, these are based on the exact moments of the time-coded tags. For example, let's say we need to find some close-up shots of the contestants posing. We can go back to Strada and search for face, and we get a number of results. My producer told me that the shots she's looking for were shot with the drone. So I can go to my drone bin, and since I already have face in my search, it shows me two clips. Both of these clips are a little over 1 minute each. If I open the analysis browser, I can see this take is a series of close-ups of the two contestants that goes on for about 1 minute and 17 seconds. The tag for face shows me when Strada recognized prominent faces in the shot. So how does this help us? Well, since these tag moments are captured in the Strada metadata analysis, we can go back to Premiere Pro, locate the face bin that Strada already created, and grab clips 96 and 97 and load them in a timeline. Even though the original clips were longer, Strada's AI analysis already trimmed them. So this selects timeline is less than 20 seconds, which makes it faster for me to find a moment that I like. If I wanted another shot of the man and woman, I can just go back to my face bin of subclips. And I like this one of Richard flexing, and I like this one of Beck running. But I don't have to rely on the automatic bins to use the search functions. Strada inserts the metadata into the column called log note. Now you can see the tags that live in the log notes, and I can combine them together. For example, what if I wanted a shot of Beck backpacking by the lake? In this view, I have 181 clips visible. If I search for lake, it's reduced down to 62. If I add the tag woman, it goes down to 11 clips. And if I add the tag backpack, we see the results go down to 1, which is the only moment in which Beck is seen backpacking by the lake. And all of this was generated in Strada completely automatically in the background. Lastly, let's go to Avid Media Composer. We start with exporting an ALE from Strada, which contains all our analytics. We already have our media loaded into Avid, but there's a few steps that we need to do before we can import our ALE. First, we select all our media and navigate to Clip, Modify, Modify Clip, then choose Select Source. We want to change our tape name to match our Strada ALE, so we can change it to Avid and hit OK. Then we right-click to create a custom column, which we'll call Keywords. Now we can select our files, click Input, Import Media, Show Options, then Select Options, then head to the Shot Log tab and select Merge Events with Known Master Clips and hit OK. When I import the ALE, I can see all the Strada keywords loaded into Media Composer. To take advantage of Avid's quick search, go to the Window menu, then Bin Settings, then change the search parameters from only the name column to searching for all columns. Now when we search in a bin, Avid will automatically filter out clips in that bin that are not found in the keywords. Unfortunately, Avid does not have a time code-based automated subclipping resource like Final Cut, Resolve, and Premiere have. However, it does allow you to search the entire clip based on these tags. So we have added a lot of search power to Media Composer using Strada's AI engine, which should speed up the editing process. Some people have asked me, like, are you just getting on the AI train because it's convenient and it's hot right now? And the answer is no. The reason I'm supportive of AI is because I want to see it used in utility forms. I think that most of the AI that is going to be extremely helpful to the creative community is AI that finds mundane tasks and does them for you. And if you can eliminate a mundane task, then you can spend more time doing the creative ones. And so we're out here trying to shoot like normal and see if AI can help specify and speed up our ability to find what we're looking for in post. And if AI can do that, it means the editor can spend more time putting together a story producer and a director can spend more time crafting that story because they're able to search for things quicker. I think that makes stories better. I think that should increase collaboration. And good creative people have these creative teams and they trust each other. So there you have it. Strada's AI analysis engine, populated with thousands of automatic tags, now traveling into the most popular nonlinear editors. We've come a long way, but we're still just getting started. And we're at the point where we're now asking for your help. If you think Strada's AI search can help your workflow, please sign up for the app at strada.tech and then send us an email at beta@strada.tech and tell us about what you saw today and we'll get you in the beta program. We need to know what about this workflow works and where you think we need to improve it. So I invite you to be among the first to let the Strada AI engine change the way that you log and search your footage forever.